don't know if you know it or not, but there's a single coenzyme found in the body that is deficient in persons with Parkinson's disease. Now, most of, if not all of you know, that dopamine is a neurotransmitter in the brain that's lacking due to the cells that produce dopamine dying off in the brain. What you may not know is that even though Parkinson's disease technically lives in the brain, it really is more than a brain disorder. Really, it's a metabolic disorder disguised as a brain disease. I think you'll understand what I mean by that a little bit more as we progress through this episode. I'm not going to delay you any further. We're going to go right into the introduction. And on the other side, I'm going to be telling you about this important coenzyme that's a dinucleotide that helps to ensure that you have increased motivation and engagement and less chance of developing REM sleep behavioral disorder as a person with Parkinson's disease. I'll see you on the other side of the introduction. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast, and hit it.
Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing. And for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show.
Okay, so I'm not going to keep you in suspense any longer. The star of the show is NAD, which is the coenzyme nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. So I'm going to tell you a little bit more about NAD in a moment, but before I do that, I want to remind you of just how crucial NAD is and why. Now, in multiple episodes of the podcast, we've talked about mitochondria and how important they are for bodily processes. In short, mitochondria are kind of like the signal core of your cells. They produce our chief energy source, ATP, or adenosine triphosphate. Without ATP, we literally, as human beings, would not survive. ATP primarily is produced in a chemical process called the Krebs cycle or the citric acid cycle. The human body is so incredible and so efficient. You can take one glucose molecule and turn it into 38 total ATP molecules produced. I just want to take a second to geek out on just how big a process this is and how much is being produced in the body. The brain alone has literally billions of cells. And you think of all the other cells throughout the entire rest of the body, all the ATP being produced by the glucose that we take in through diet. Obviously, we need more than just glucose to survive, but that just goes to show you the efficiency of the body in producing energy from as little as possible. But here's the kicker. Without NAD, this process is impossible. NAD in multiple places along the Krebs cycle is responsible for accepting electrons from molecules that are part of the process of producing that ATP. That's as detailed into biochemistry and cellular biology that we need to get today. Let's move on to the studies that have shown why this is crucial in persons with Parkinson's disease. Early in 2022, there was a landmark study called the NAD-PARK study. Now, the long and the short of that study, and the reason it's a landmark study, is because it really showed the relationship between NAD and clinical improvements in Parkinson's disease, as well as decreased inflammation, not only in the serum, like in the blood, but also in the cerebrospinal fluid. Now, there were 30 subjects in this study who were newly diagnosed individuals with Parkinson's disease. They took NAD via nicotinamide riboside, which chemically converted to NAD where the body needed it. Again, the study showed decreased inflammation in the serum and in the cerebrospinal fluid, as well as mild clinical improvements in those subjects. Now, while the NAD-PARK study wasn't exactly groundbreaking research that was supposed to cure Parkinson's or something grandiose like that, it did open the door for further research into showing the effects of NAD as a potential to be neuroprotective in persons with Parkinson's disease. The next study I'm going to share with you was published just in February of 2023. And that was a study by Dr. Lori Mishley et al., where they looked at the deficiencies of NAD as well as ATP in persons with Parkinson's disease. Essentially, what Dr. Mishley and her colleagues wanted to know in this 2023 published study was not only to talk about and highlight the deficiencies of ATP and NAD in those with Parkinson's disease, particularly in the muscles of the body, but to see the impact of increased NAD on ATP, if that increased the ATP production in those same muscles. So they studied muscle groups in two areas, in the, one in the leg and one in the arm or the hand. And the participants in this study, rather than being newly diagnosed, were mid-stage or so-called mid-stage at Honan-Yar 2 to 3. What they found was that ATP max and NAD were significantly lower in persons with Parkinson's compared to the controls in the study. Something else very intriguing in their research was that decreased ATP in the muscle was correlated with not only decreased motivation and engagement, but also with increased incidence of REM sleep behavioral disorder. They actually found a linear relationship there. So as ATP increased, then levels of RBD incidence were lower, and engagement was higher, and motivation was higher. So it makes perfect sense based on what we said earlier that increased NAD can directly lead to increased ATP production. It's mind-blowing to me in this conversation we're having to think about the fact that we've learned for all these years, decades, that dopamine is the reason that people have the symptoms of Parkinson's disease that they have. And that is largely true, but it's incredible to think that the cell damage issues that are caused at the substantia nigra in the brain, and indeed other cells, because we know that the mitochondria are damaged in these cells. In fact, Dr. Mishley in her study alludes to the fact that we've known about mitochondrial changes in persons with Parkinson's since the 1980s. It's just incredible to me that Parkinson's disease, even though it's technically a brain disease, is truly a metabolic disorder disguised as a brain disease. That really is food for thought, in my opinion. It also leaves me to ask the question, why are we always treating the symptoms of Parkinson's disease and not going to the root causes? There's some cynical answers I could give to that, and you probably have some of those thoughts too. But I am hopeful that since this is coming to light in the 2000s, we're going to have more research that will hopefully move the needle forward a lot sooner than later. By the way, and this is my personal opinion, I wouldn't follow some of the advice you see online about diet and Parkinson's disease, even from some of the large organizations that supposedly are helping persons with Parkinson's. That's a controversial thing to say, but in light of what we know, what we absolutely know about mitochondrial science and its relationship to Parkinson's disease, it's incredible to me that there are organizations out there literally recommending that we follow the government MyPlate recommendations for dietary guidance for persons with Parkinson's disease. I'm sorry, but that's just not the answer, folks. That's all I'm going to say on my soapbox today. Thanks for being here for my TED Talk. Thanks for watching as always and listening. I do hope that you'll subscribe and follow on YouTube and in your podcast app, wherever you might be listening. Thank you for being here for our journey and for supporting us on the channel and bringing this information to you. I hope this is new information that it's going to spur you to research this more. And I hope you learned something today. That's the number one thing that I wanted to bring to you. Look forward to seeing you in the next episode. As always, be empowered. I'll catch you next time.